every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You know, I woke up this morning and I saw a whole lot of people in Minnesota who had gathered together. And what I saw was I saw sheep. I saw sheep who have wandered away and lost in how to solve a problem. And then I woke up to call one of my friends, and I was telling her that even in situation that seems like it's justified, it still has to pass security. It has to pass the security of God's word. If it does not pass the security of God's word, then we are going to endanger ourselves. And I say that because if they are sheep and they have gone and done things that sheep will do, they got out of the pasture. And I understand why they may have gotten out of the pasture. But they are sheep, which makes me wonder, where are our shepherds? For this many people to go and make a decision that there's a problem and the sheep has to be the one to solve it. And while I was speaking to her this morning, she said, you know what a great divide is? The great divide is on every corner. We separate ourselves in our churches. We separate ourselves in what we say the Lord has told us. We separate ourselves in how we see each other. And so when you do that, then sheep will do what they do. Sheep are hurt. And when they gather together, if you can ever get them to calm down, they will always listen to the shepherd. Every time. They will listen to the shepherd. That's the way God made us, and that's why we're called sheep. And one reason why they don't hear the shepherd is because they recognize that's not his voice. Yet all those people, and I've seen it happen in the Word of God, when somebody stood up in Paul's defense, and they said, brothers, if we don't do something to get people to listen, because when people are hurt, they dismiss all parameters of everything, and that's what I see going on. And the word says, if my people which are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. And I'm not just saying pray, but again, these are sheep that have gone astray because we have missing shepherds. The shepherds have gotten a word from the Lord that cannot be confirmed. So every time the sheep get to a point that they don't know where to eat, they just go scatter everywhere. Take us back to this book right here and only tell us what the shepherd said, and we will hear. We'll hear him every time, because he said, my sheep, these wonderful people know my voice, and a stranger, that you can't do nothing with them. And if we don't get the word of God, if the shepherds don't get the word of God and begin to get the microphone, because I reach as many as I can, and I know that I don't have a microphone. At least, I don't know if I got one or not, but I do know that we got to stop talking about my church has got a title of all these titles that we programmed it to be, and go back to the word and just let the word be the word. I'm not going to title Exodus 2. I'm just going to read it. I can't give God's word a title. It's part of what he said. The title of my subject is God. God speaks. So I pray, because if we really truly feared God, like the women did when they were told to take the babies and kill every male child, it's an honor. I fear God. I ain't doing that. And then they would call before the government and say, why have you not carried out our orders? And then they said, because them women spit out babies too fast, and by the time we get there, them babies are already born. So we got to be able to say we fear God. And how do you know you fear God? Because you won't do what a sheep is not going anywhere except it gets God's permission. Father, may I? That's a game we used to play as children. Father, may I? Mother, may I? I think it was mother, may I? But what I'm saying is the reason why that many sheep in Minnesota have gathered is because one of their little sheep got hurt by another sheep. And so all the other sheep got together and decided we got to fix this. Sheep can't fix it. Only the shepherd can. You ain't going to get nowhere doing that, because I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. According to the book of Revelations. Hey, Tammy. According to the book of Revelation, it says that I will remove my peace. I'll remove it. And that's just one part of it. It's a whole list of things that God said when these things happen. You don't want God to remove his peace, because what you're doing is, are you looking at the long-term thing? Yes, something went wrong. But is that the way to solve it? Because when you call somebody, that's called the police, those are God's angels. If they get in trouble, I promise you God knows how to take care of every last battle that he employed. You got to trust him enough to know that if they are assigned by God for the lawless and they do something wrong, the punishment that you can do together collectively cannot be nothing compared to what God can do. You can't do it. You're a sheep. And these sheep are hurt. But one thing I can't understand about our sheep when they get hurt, we only go after certain kind of people that hurt us. And we hurt our sheep every day. I don't get that, and I ain't getting off into that. Because I know when people are hurt, they do what... I know people are tired. I know people are tired. I understand that. I've been in a body of dark skin all my life, and if I don't know what it feels like to be this color, but guess what? I don't have you up. I don't have you up. And I got 6 sons. I don't have you up. Because I know you don't know no better. Because if you knew any better, you knew you were my brother too. And how can you kill... How could Cain kill his brother? How could you do what you do to your brother? At the end of the day, every knee shall bow. Y'all gonna realize God was not lying. God meant what he said. He said, I only speak my word. Speak the oracles of my word. Say the training of my word. When you go through the book of Genesis, God never had to back up his word and say, oh, I ain't mean to tell Jacob that. I'm sorry. He never apologized, because he was few with his words. And when he spoke, he said the same thing to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's just a keeper of his word. So I pray that the people that's got the influence over people, you know, I may get a few people to listen to me, and I don't think that, let me tell y'all something about them numbers that roll out on, they say how many people viewing you. Them numbers not true. People show up and they look at you for a minute, they gone on back in the kitchen cooking. They might have passed by you and it counted. This is man-made stuff. And then that people will follow some, because I don't look at no numbers. I can't look at no numbers. That's a waste of time. I mean, I might pass by it, but I'm just saying I do see some people get a lot of people. But I promise you, if you a shepherd and you watching those numbers, you can forget them numbers don't work. Because sometimes I pass by, I don't stay there long. Not all the time. Sometimes I do. I go to YouTube and pick what I want to hear. And that's what people do to me on Facebook. Some people ain't thinking about what I'm saying. But that don't mean I'm not going to get on here, because somebody might be thinking. Especially if I'm building a repertoire. How do you say that word? Repertoire for my children in the future. Because I paid plenty of dollars to do this. A lot of money. I finally got where I just paid my internet. And that kind of high. But I'm saying that I pray that these sheep will hear, because they will hear. A black man will hear. I know he will. I know that he will. Anything this good, who wouldn't listen to this? They just don't hear it. They don't hear it enough. They don't hear the goodness of God's word. That's why they trying to take matters in their own hand. He said, because they hurt. And God understands the pain, because what we're getting ready to talk about now, the cry that's coming out from these people right here, are cries that hurt. And God heard them with their ears, his ears. And he said, I'm going to send you a deliverer. And that's what he got to do now. We are fighting sheep. It don't work like that. Just because there's a black sheep and a white sheep, we all sheep. And every last one of us got to bend them arthritis knees, if you got it. You got to bend them knees, some kind of whether yours can drop or whether them knees got to go down. So I say to you, if you're a sheep, go on YouTube, get you a shepherd until you can find you somebody that'll give you this word. And just put in there, teach me how to understand Exodus 2. You might not listen to me. I have people that don't listen to me, and they'll call me, and they might compliment. I don't care who you get it from, just get the word. You know, sometimes my sons tell me all the time, Mom, I try to tell you the same thing. Oh, but I heard it through somebody else, so therefore I got it now. So don't get mad, just be glad I got it. But every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. And I say that because when God flushed the world with the water from up and down, it's raining out here, that's why I'm turned in a different direction. It's just raining. I got something in my mouth. But when God told Noah and his three sons repopulated this earth, that was all of us, all the sheep. We're the sheep. He repopulated. Some of us went more to the west and we didn't get as much sun. Some of us stayed right up under the equator. And some of us went a little bit to the east side, and they a little bit rounder. And we all was baked, and some was baked longer than others. But we fight sheep every day. And I'm telling you, I know those wonderful people in Minnesota who are gathering together to make a call. See, the outcome of that is that one of these days, somebody's not going to answer when you call their police. They're not going to answer. They're going to have to think about it. And what if there's a great divide? Because everybody out there wasn't black. I didn't see it. I just talked to a young man. I couldn't handle it. But because I know a lot of people in Minnesota are not my shade. At least I think so. That's what I think. And but sheep don't act like that. Lost sheep act like that. And I know that as soon as somebody calm them down and they hear the word of the Lord, they'll come back and be guided by their shepherd. He said, my people perish, and they do this because they don't know me. They don't know my word. Because when I told you that Jephthaham and another boy named Jephthaham and what's that other boy name? I got to look it up now and start talking about it. Jephthah, the sons of Noah. He had the three. But three, trying to get that other boy name. He said he told them sons, be fruitful and multiply. Genesis 9, and God blessed Noah and his sons and said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. When you trust God, you'll know that God said that. And that means that you won't see nobody but sheep. You'll see all of us as we all need God. Jephthah, Ham, and what the boy name? Ham. Jephthah, Ham, and Shem. Sorry, Shem, I couldn't remember your name. But Jephthah went over there to the European nation. Ham stayed there in Africa, and Shem stayed over there with the Israelis. So we all brothers. And if we start looking at each other like sheep, your wool might be one shade and mine is another, but we all shade, we all sheep. And those, Father, and I thank you for your precious word toward those sheep. That there'll be if you have to send the rain to send those sheep home. Calm them down, Lord. Let them understand that you got a plan and you have not left us comfortless. And I pray that you raise up only those shepherds that will hear you so that the sheep will know who to follow. Because I'm going to tell you, sheep will follow him. Every time they'll do it. Every time they hear a word from God, they're going to come to that shepherd. They're not your sheep as human beings. Oh, Lord, it rain about to get me. All right. Anyway, I love y'all. I'm a sheep, and I'm trying to back. I'm going to speak as a... I'm going to the shepherd and see what he got to say. And so I can go in his house and get out of the rain. Y'all think I need to go in now? Anyway, let me try. Maybe. I got this porch, but anyway. Father, let me see only your word and bless the sheep that hear, that we spread each other and love one another and only be encouraged to know that you have not forsaken, neither have you forgotten. And Father, even at this time when we got the coronavirus, we got all these other distractions, help us to go home until you finish the work. And let's not be distracted by anything that the enemy says. Correct that was wrong and do it the way you would have it done. And I cry out to you in behalf of all the sheep that's lost. And I pray for every shepherd that if you're going to be called to say that God called you, that you will only speak those things that have been written in this book. All right. Amen. In Jesus' name. And there went a man out of the house of Levi. This is one of Abraham's sons. Well, his son, but this is one of Jacob's sons. One of his kinfolk. Now, Jacob is dead. Levi, the man, is dead, but he left some descendants here. And there went a man out of the house of Levi and took a wife, a daughter of Levi. So he got somebody that was related to him. They both Levi. They was up under the same tribe. And the woman conceived. He married this woman and she got pregnant. And bare a son right there over there in Egypt, in the land of Goshen. And the woman conceived and bare a son. And when she saw him that he was a goodly child, she hid him 3 months. Why she hide that boy? Because the king had put out a decree killing all the boys. And so she hid him. Oh, I might need another chair. Let's see if I can get somebody to bring me. Can anybody bring me another chair? So I can get back out of the rain. Yeah, put out a decree to kill every boy. And this woman hid her child for 3 months. She said, boy, you getting too big. And when she could not... And somebody said that she gave birth at 6 months and she couldn't hide herself because she was sticking out too much. I ain't saying that. That woman had that baby. I read a lot, somebody said that. But she hid him for 3 months. That's what she did. And that boy was 3 months old. And when she could not no longer hide him, she took for him an ark of bulrushes and daubed it with slime and with pitch. And put the child, that boy was a child, therein, and she laid him in the flags by the river's brink. Now that part right there, that is verse 3. That got my attention. You know, the movie Moses, they had him in a little pretty basket floating down there in the water. But that is not what it looked like. Because I went and looked this morning and my focus was, this boy was put in something that mama had to hurry up and put together. So she went and got some of that plant that can stand the water. That plant that can stand water. And the Bible says she took some and smeared it on them. That's what I looked them words up. And that's that stuff that they, in Mississippi, when I was young, they would be making the street and they had a real foul, real asphalt. And they'll put that stuff in there and she took that asphalt and she made that thing and she smeared it. She was in a hurry. And she closed the Bible. She pitched. What is that word, pitched? Slam with pitch. And I looked that stuff up and I said, now the only thing I saw with a pitch was, like it had something to do with the volume, the sound. So I believe that she made a thing out of that, the plants that she could find that can handle the weeds, and she smeared it on there in a hurry to get that boy out of there. And she made it so if he cried, there didn't nobody hear but the right person. It didn't smell good. It wasn't in a place, and he wasn't putting no lovely picnic basket. No, 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 no. And you know who I thought about when I saw that? Jesus. I thought about Jesus was born in a manger where there was smelly stuff, nothing that what he was born in had scent around it. It was not in a likely place, and Moses was given Moses was born in a similar place, was not born, was carried in the ark. The Bible says he was carried in the ark. What that word said? She said she took for him an ark of bulrushes. She put him in an ark. Not no big old ark like what Noah built, but she put him in a covering that could ride on water. And it wasn't a pretty basket. So if I had to redo that movie, I'm going to be the mama trying to get my baby out of here. And then I'm going to tell his big sister what happened then. And she put him on the Nile River. Now, if that girl had to put that, God had them plants already. Let me tell y'all something about God. God let every plant, everything that's supposed to be, that bulrush that she took, that plant, that they said that was a type of paper that the writing of the word of God was written on that was so thick that it could be preserved. So she took that paper, that just say she rolled up some of that word paper, and she made that basket, and she smeared that thing real fast, and then she put him in an ark. Ain't that good? She put him in an ark. Like God said, I'm going to send you somebody that's going to keep my people, help my people. I put Noah in an ark. I got Moses in an ark, little bitty baby ark. Oh, Lord, ain't that good? Ain't that good? Ain't so he put him in the ark, and she did it in a hurry, and it stank, and whatever did God did, he kept the odor from making the baby do nothing but ride down. It might have put him a little sleep, I don't know. But then she set him on the Nile River, and that's a long river, and if that boy had got caught up in that river, Moses would probably have been all over the place. So now he stayed within the bushes that was close so that he can go right to where he was supposed to be. Can't nobody orchestrate this thing but God. God heard the cries of the people. He heard the cries of the injustices. He heard the cries, and he made a baby born, made the right tree be made for the mama, made the mortar and the slime that she needs, or whatever it was that she needed. The bull rested and dubbed it with, dub means he smeared it. It wasn't in no pretty order. With slime, sticky stuff, no black stuff around it. With pitch. I can't, every time I look up that word pitch, like I said, I know it probably got something to do with plant, but what I saw was Moses might have been crying and he wasn't finna get no attention but the woman that was supposed to get it. And put the child therein, and she laid it in the flags by the river brink. In other words, the identified place of Pharaoh. She was coming out there, and that boy was already ready. God had that thing so orchestrated. God has this day orchestrated. We don't have to leave God's pasture to go fishing. I told you, those sheep that God see in Minnesota and in Atlanta, wherever people are hurting, God see, so I'm not going to leave you. You're my sheep. I just want the shepherds to ride up and let you hear me so I know that y'all know what to do in conflict time. And while he was going down there on that little old roller, on the little ark coaster, and his sister stood afar off. She said, I can't get, you know, I'm looking at my baby brother to know what would be done to him. In other words, she knew the direction he was going, but she said, I'm just watching to see what's going to happen. He didn't just go out there and say, I'm just going to send him, the Lord to take care of him. No. The Lord said, little sister, big sister, go with your brother. And the daughter of Pharaoh came down. That girl had that thing mapped out. That girl must be at work on time, because she know what time Sister Pharaoh was going to come out that building. And the daughter of Pharaoh came down to wash herself in the river. Now, somebody said that wasn't his daughter, that was his wife. They said that was Pharaoh's wife. But the word said that's her daughter. And if it was his wife, I'm going to stick with the word. Daughter means daughter, wife means wife to me. And her maiden walked along by the river. That lady had herself and her maids out there. And when she saw the ark, when that lady saw the ark among the flags, what is that over there? And it looks sort of strange. What is that? She sent her maid to go get that for me. I see. What is that? And when she had opened it, she saw the child. And behold, the babe started crying. The babe went, ooh! When she saw the child, the baby said, ah. And she had compassion on him. Come here, sugar. Oh, he was, look at the, And she had compassion on him and said, this is one of the Hebrew children. This of the Hebrews' children. And say later, I know, you know, her daddy had put out a warrant for all babies. You know, that's got to be crazy that a grown man trying to put a hit list on a baby. You know this world messed up. And all he was doing one day, them all them Hebrews, they're getting out of control over there. I got to do something. He just sitting there, them folk wasn't doing nothing. And they plotted. He plotted. And he had people that worked for him. And he carried out his plan. And he got a hit list out on the baby. Now, you know that's a problem. It's a problem. How you going to take a baby? Just like the devil. From the time that the word says, and that woman stood pregnant in the sun, in the area of the sun, and the devil came straight out to grab that baby. And he been trying to grab babies. Because you know how important it is to get a baby. Everything. Because what we learn as a baby, we never forget. Train them up in the way they should go. When they get old, they ain't going to forget it. Whatever I know how to do as a child, that's what I'm picking up on now. I walk, talk, learn all that as a child. Read, learn that as a child. Learn my multiplication as a child. A lot of stuff I learned as a child. I was learning how to play the piano, but I stopped. My daddy should have made me keep on paying all that money for that stuff and didn't make me do it. I hate that now. So I say, parents, if your child is doing something, they cry. The Bible said, don't slack the goodness from teaching your kid because they cry. Let them know that I'm looking out for you and do what you got to do to give your kid some type of skill to do. Anyway, back to the oracles of God. She opened up that thing and heard that baby whining, crying. And she had compassion on him. That's what made her move. Compassion will make you break the law in a right way. Where it make you say, I'm going to do this in spite of the law. I'm going to love you in spite of the law. I'm going to love you if you don't look like me. I'm going to love you if you did do that to me. Compassion. She had compassion on him. And she said, this one is the, in other words, I ain't even got no business touching you because you're not my kind. You're not my color. But compassion will make you take heed to the cry. And that's what's going on. The sheep are crying. Somebody, Father, let somebody have compassion. Somebody's got a microphone greater than mine, but they don't have one greater than yours. You can use mine. I ain't gonna hold back nothing on God's word. And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, the little girl. Wait, I skipped the verb. All right, she had compassion and then said his sister to Pharaoh's daughter. Then his sister said, Sister Pharaoh, shall I go and call you a nurse of the Hebrew women that she may nurse the child for you? I need to talk about this little girl or this daughter. Can I go get my mama to help keep on taking care of my brother for you? That's what she might as well said. That's my little brother. Can I take him back home to my mama and tell her to take care of him for you? And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, yeah, go. And the maid went and called the child's own mom. Look at God. Go put that boy back in the arm of your mom. And Pharaoh's daughter said unto her, wait a minute, girl. Let me tell you something. Take this little boy, take this child away and nurse him for me. For me now, nurse him for me. Talking to Moses' big sister. And I will give you money. I'll give you wages. Look at God. I'm gonna send your own baby back, and I'm gonna pay you for keeping your own child. Isn't that look at that check? I'm gonna pay you to keep your own baby. Look at God. Can I borrow Moses' mama? We're gonna call her name later. Anything that you do for me, I'll pay. Moses' mama babysitted her own son and got paid. That's God. And the woman took the child and nursed it. So evidently the woman took the child. Let me see if she always been called a woman. And I made her walk along the river. So she wasn't no little old girl. The Bible said, and the woman took the child and back to her mama. Took the child and nursed it. And the child grew. He didn't stay no baby. And she brought him unto Pharaoh's daughter. She kept her word. She didn't go back on her word. This is my son. I just got a problem with giving you my son for real. This is my son. Oh, no. And the child grew, and she brought him unto Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. So when we write these movies, if we just go check this word out and get them little things that we skip, we might be telling the truth. And she called his name what? Moses. And she said, because I drew you out of the water. Yep, because he sure didn't come out of your womb. I drew you out of the water. That lady liked that boy. And she said, look at him now. She didn't have to change no diapers. She escaped all that. Let me pay your mom to do all that nursing. He had to be breastfeeding and trying to teach him how to talk and to walk. Go on back over there and tell it. Find somebody to take care of and bring him back when he get big enough that I can handle him. And it came to pass in those days when Moses was grown. That he went out unto his brothers and looked on their burdens, looked at all what they were doing. And he spied an Egyptian smiting an Hebrew, one of his brothers. Now the word said he went out and spied him on and looked at his brother. He was like, what the man doing to that man? Now the movie got it so well, he found out that that was his brother, but I'm gonna stick with the word. And he saw that he probably knew that he, you know, he was a bit, let me tell you something, kids catch on when they small. And Moses knew something, I guess. That's me trying to write my own script. And he saw the Egyptian hitting the Hebrew, one of his brothers. Moses might have just by nature just said, you know, like, I'm like this. I get in the other folks' business when I see you hurting somebody. I get in there so fast until like, that's what that got to do with you? I can't help. Don't do that woman like that. Don't do that man like that. Better teach these people the word. You better open up this book and make this book be as simple as it is. This is almost like rock you and tell you a story and the child to be listening and remembering. That's what I be waiting on these pastors to do, to stop this entertainment and performing and be a, if you're going to be a shepherd, what the word says? The harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. The people that's supposed to be laboring in the word are few. People don't want to read no word. It's easy just go grab a script. Let me see what I can say. I can say, and the child grew. You ain't going to stay long. You going to grow up. Yes, you are. I am performing. And it came to pass that in those days when Moses was grown, that he went out unto his brothers and looked on their burdens, and he spied an Egyptian. Oh, I see that boy smiting a Hebrew. One of his brothers. And he looked this way. And he looked that way. And he looked this way and that way. And when he saw that there was nobody, no man, he slew the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. Now Moses, you can't be hiding nobody in sand. You know that ain't how the Egyptian do things like that. Well, I'm sure that if he was a Pharaoh, they're going to wrap him up like a mummy, but I'm sure they had a burial process. And then if Moses was, according to the movie, Moses had the power to make a decision, but Moses knew something ain't right what I just did, because let's see what happened. Because he hid it. That's what we do when we know we ain't right. We're going to hide it. Just as sure as we do it wrong, we're going to do what? Hide it. Look at your neck. I ain't playing with y'all. I don't play that. And when he went out of the on the second day, Moses said, I done did that. I got my done wiped. Get the sand on me. Now, Moses' intent was to stop this guy. So you stop treating that man like that. But that's not how you fix things, people. You don't fix things by going out there killing nobody. You don't go out there taking no police brick, no brick and busting up all the cars. Some of them men, good men. Some of those men are fathers. Some of those are women. Some of those people don't have no idea what's it. Some of the people probably been sick and they ain't even realize what happened to my car. And all of a sudden, just because they wear the name that they are protector of the land, and you done got mad and just did everything. And then you ain't gonna admit it more than likely. The Egyptian and hid him in the sand. Excuse me. And when he went out of them the second day, Moses got up the next day after he done killed a man. Behold, two men of the Hebrews strove together. He saw them, man, you give me my stuff back. That ain't none of mine. Man, would you stop? That's mine. It's not yours. That's mine. Why are you looking at my woman like that? Why? What? When you going to pay me back? Whatever they were doing, they were striving. And when he went out the second day, behold, two men of the Hebrews strove together. And he said unto him that did the wrong, wherefore smitest thou thy fellow? What you hit that man like that for? Why y'all fighting over there? What you doing smiting your brother? That man looked at Moses like, you talking to me? You talking to me? Me? Wait a minute. Me and you gonna stop for a minute. You talking to me? And he said, who made you a prince and a judge? Moses thought, over us. Intendest thou to kill me as you killed the Egyptian? Ha! Cat got your tongue? And Moses got scared, fear, and said, surely this thing is known. Man, I'm going to tell y'all something. It didn't take a camera back then to find out who really did it. And how you going to come at me knowing it's because I know what I did and hid it. I mean, what I thought I hid, somebody saw it. And he got scared. And he said, who made you a prince and a judge over us? Intendest thou to kill me like you killed the Egyptian? And Moses feared and said, surely this thing is known. That we always talking to ourselves and say, surely this thing is known. All you know is this guy knew it. That's what you really know. You know he spoke it, so he know it. Moses said in his head, surely this thing is known. Well, you're probably right. Now, when Pharaoh heard this thing, he sought to kill Moses. But Moses fled from the face of Pharaoh and dwelt in the land of Midian, and he sat down by a well. Moses, I better get up out of here. I'm gone. Now, the priest of Midian had seven daughters, and they came and drew water and filled a trough to water their father's flock. So the girl said, girl, let's go get up and get this water for this flock. And that was some heavy stuff, water heavy. Unless they had a wheelbarrow or something. No, they probably had some type of animal. And the shepherd came and drove them away. In other words, the shepherds came out there, y'all get away, mule. They probably were men. And they saw them women. And the women had the water, and the shepherd said, y'all move. And he drove them away. But Moses couldn't help it. Told you, when Moses sees something going wrong, I don't care if I am running from somebody else. I still see some problems over here. But Moses stood up and helped them and watered their flocks. And y'all better back off. Now, I ain't gonna tell y'all what I just did before I got here, but you better leave these girls alone. You better back off. And Moses couldn't help it. God said, I got the right one now. This boy right here ain't scared of me. He sees something going wrong. He did wrong for the right reason, but right doing wrong for the right reason don't make it right. Mm-mm. God just want to use your passion and your compassion. But he wanted to be the God of it, so he can show you how to regulate that thing. God saw Moses had that in him. Whatever it is in us, God can use it. If you're good at anything, God can use that. If you're a good math teacher, God can use that. If you're a good fisherman, God can use it. He always, you notice that Jesus, when he came, he never picked up nobody who wasn't doing nothing. Everybody he told to come follow me, he said, you good at that, come follow me. He didn't call nobody to sleep. Tell them sleep people wake up. Now the priest of Midian had seven daughters, and they came to draw water and fill the trough with water their father's flock. And the shepherds came and drove them away, but Moses stood up and helped them and watered their flock. He said, you ain't got nothing to worry about, ladies. Ladies, I got this. And when they came to, these guys bagged them out the way. And when they came to Raul, their father, he said, how is it that y'all got back here so quick? What happened? Y'all known to take longer than that. And they said, an Egyptian, let me say that because somebody told me, said, Brenda, you are talking to the world, so you have to be careful how you sound. So let me say that a little bit better. And when they came to Raul, their father, he said, how is it that you are come so soon today? You normally don't get back to about noon, but what y'all doing back about 8 o'clock? What happened? Because the strength of a man can get things done quicker than a woman. And then the Lord was with him. And they said, an Egyptian delivered us out of the hand of the shepherds. Now, what made them call Moses an Egyptian? Was it because he had on something that only Egyptians wore, or some type of tattoo, or some type of mascara? It was something that made them know he was an Egyptian. And they said, an Egyptian delivered us out of the hand of the shepherds. And also, not only did he make them guys get back and leave us alone, and also drew water enough for us and watered the flock. Look at what Moses did. Moses said, I told the enemy to be gone and fed my people and the flock and help the ladies. Look at God. And we thought Samson is strong, and he is. Moses said, I done moved the shepherds. I done helped the sisters, and it's 7 to them, and it's just one of me. And I watered the flock. And he said unto his daughters, and where is he? Why is it that you have left the man? Call him that I may eat bread. Say, go get that man and let him come over here and have some dinner. And Moses was content to dwell in with the man. Moses said, I kind of like you. And he gave Moses Zipporah, his daughter. He said, I'd like you to marry my oldest. I like it like that. Because if I was to get married, I'm going to marry somebody as quick as to stay out of sin. If he's a good man and recommend it. I'm just talking that, y'all. I ain't saying that. But I'm just saying, I ain't wasting no time doing a lot of dating. Shoot, I can't be starting nothing you can't finish. We got to get married. Oh, they can't be doing it. You don't know who, when you do marry them, you date them all that time, they turn into a husband after you get them. And Moses was content to dwell with the man, and he gave Moses Zipporah, his daughter, the oldest girl. And she bare him a son. Girl got pregnant. And he called his name Gershom. For he said, I have been a stranger in a strange land. These people, when they like Moses, that name means you got drawn out of water. And then the story of the next chapter of his life, he said, I done been a stranger, and also I'm in a strange land. What is that y'all doing up in here? I'm strange and you strange too. To me, Moses says, I have named my son a stranger in a strange land. And it came to pass in the process of time. That means some years went by. Stuff happened. And it came to pass in process of time, that the king of Egypt, he died. And the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. They said, Lord, we so tired. We so tired of what they're doing to us. We so tired. Every time we have a baby boy, we got to try to hide him. Because I don't know how long that decree was put in place. But it ain't stopping them. God, you remember, I don't know if you remember, but God gonna have, when Elijah thought that all the priests were gone, God said, boy, please, I've been hiding folk. I got me 7,000. Anyway. And the children of Israel, God said, you ain't finna get rid of, I'm God. And the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. Let me tell you how foolish Pharaoh was. If I had a son, I know you're gonna kill him. I'm gonna dress him up in all that pink and everything I can. You ain't finna get my boy. I'm gonna wrap that blanket up in pink. No, he gonna be acting like a man, but you ain't finna take my baby. I don't know what I would've done back then. I'd have dug me a hole in the ground and made me a basement. I don't know how them people did that, but we're going to find out how many men that he didn't kill, because they're going to grow up and they had to be young when he would kill them. And it came to pass in the process of time that the king of Egypt died, and the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. And they cried, and their cry came up unto God by reason of their bondage. That's why I say the only reason we act like that is because sheep get tired. I wish and I pray that this video goes into every home and everybody that you will somehow, if it don't come through me, let it come through somebody who's saying and agree with the word of God, that the lost sheep understand that God hears your cry. And one of these days, we're going to have to stop putting on and say, that's a black sheep, that's a white sheep, because it don't matter what sheep. Because right down the street from me, it was a 16-year-old sheep got shot by his dad. And I ain't never seen nobody start no riot to find out why it happened. And I don't like it when we do that. I don't like it when we do to each other. Because at the end of the day, all of us are brothers. At the end, every knee going to bow down and you're going to say, Jesus, he already told you. That's your brother. Your brother didn't do the right thing. And your brother had a problem. In fact, both brothers had a problem. And we just need to cry out to the Father. And I'm going to tell you what the sheep going to do. Give the sheep the word. I'm telling you, I know what a black man would do if you tell him the truth. He'll listen. Oh, you know that, Brenda, because I got six of them. If you tell them the truth, if you can get their attention, they'll listen. You might have to say it a little bit. Hey, baby, can I talk to you? It's a way to talk. But we just need somebody to be able to talk in a way where they'll hear God and not me. And they cried, and their cry came up to God by reason of the bondage. God said, I understand. You think God don't see what we see? He said, God said, I see you in the palm of my hand. I see everything in my hand. Well, I can't see like God, but if you in my hand, I ought to know what's in there. And God heard their groan, and God said, I hear you. You need the police. I mean, he said, you're going to have to stop that. I ain't with you on that. It's because as sure as you get in trouble, you're going to call. Because sheep do that. They'll kill one and then they'll call them. They're just confused. Because the shepherds that supposed to be teaching my word, talking about some other than what I said. So that's why every time the sheep get in trouble, they go do what sheep do. Go get lost. And God heard their groaning, and God remembered his covenant with Abraham. He said, I'm going to do this because I owe your great-granddaddy, great-great-great-great-great-great-great-granddaddy a favor. And God heard their groaning, and God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. He said, I told your kinfolk, the people that y'all may not know, but you heard of, I made a promise to them. And God looked upon the children of Israel, and God had respect unto them. Don't lose hope, people. I know for a fact that God loved him, some black people. He loved him, some white people, too. In fact, God loved all of us, cause what? We all his sheep. I'm getting ready to go eat some real food at 12 o'clock. And I'm gonna eat the third chapter. Talk to you, love y'all, bye.